and by contributions from the PBS station, we really thank you. Thank you.
The native people of Alaska's Arctic coast. They're looking for the lone inhabitant of a small island. Last winter, Ballard dragged a cabin out here across the ice port.
I think he liked it. He's a lot warmer, I guess. And more protecting from the bears.
It was a surprise to the locals that after 28 summers living in a tent, George the Vulture had not yet been eaten by polar bears. But George is more interested in a different kind of life. Every summer, he comes to the Cooper Island to study the Guillemots. Guillemots nest on the island and catch fish in the Arctic Ocean. This year, they're not doing so well.
Thank you.
call a rare sight for this year. A lucky ship battling down an Arctic pack. If it had been one of those nasty horned skeletons, the chief probably would have ignored it. One of the adults got caught as it left the nest. George's colony has been in steady decline since the 1990s. Its numbers are now down more than a third from their peak. You can relate the fortunes of the colony directly to the steady warming that Alaska has experienced in the last few decades. At first, in the 1980s, things went well as the island became snow-free earlier in the year.
When the snow period opened up here and the ice was just offshore, things were very good for the here because they had no constraints about snow melt or snow accumulation, and they could prey offshore. As the warming continued, now the snow is melting in May, well before they even launch it. So even though now they can essentially see whenever they launch in the spring, they can't raise the ice successfully because the climate is from the top.
Thank you.